Good evening. I will just take 5 minutes. First of all, thank you to Sri B.D. Moses, founder, and Madam D. Vanja, headmistress, to invite me as a chief guest. As a chief guest, certainly I would like to address you on some points. First of all, I am happy that the school is celebrating its 31st annual day celebration. In the annals of any school, the annual day is a very sacred function and a function that everyone wants to remember. And I'm very happy with the performance of the children, the small children, the kids, and the children of the 9th and 10th class. So I wish you all the best in the endeavor that apart from educating the children, you are also training them in other arts like music and dance, it is. You know that education is a very sacred thing. It's not like the other businesses. I must congratulate the founder, the headmistress, and the teachers that they are giving their best to inculcate the best possible manners and the education. For the student, I just want to tell one or two things. Always your parents and teacher may say that you should be the first in the class. But believe me, I completed UPSC. I got 3rd rank. But in class 5th, I got 0 marks in mathematics. I am not telling a lie in front of you. But my parents were always supportive of me. In class 6, I was topper of the school. Within 1 year it happened. What I want to tell you that always give solace to your children. If no, only one children will be first, only one children will be second in the class, and only one children will be 3rd in the class. But apart from education, there are so many things today. If your child is good in sports, let him play sports. If your child is good in music, let him play music. If your child is good in singing, let him sing. Don't think that only education is the panacea of all the things. So that will be my humble request from all the teachers and the parents who are here. Don't chide your child if he comes with the lesser marks. You should always encourage him to do his best. Because these days you know that due to the peer pressure, due to the pressure from the family and the friends, many incidents happen. The children, they take the extreme step. So we should always take care of that. For the students also, I want to tell one or two things. See, last year you got 60% of the marks. So this year you should try to better yourself from the last year. You should try to get at least 65% of the marks. If last year you got 65% of the marks, this year you should try to get minimum 70% of the marks. The second thing, never tell a lie from your parents and the teacher. If you have committed any mistake, accept that. Be humble. Then only you will grow in life. Discipline is paramount and you must focus on the discipline and the character. I could take 5 minutes, then I will tell one or two things also, because he told me that children will be more interested in the cultural program, and I admit that, but at the same time I think it's an occasion to interaction with you. See, there was a king and his prime minister. The king was liking his prime minister like anything. He was respecting him like anything. Whatever the prime minister was telling, the king was accepting. So one day, the prime minister, he thought to prove in front of the king that why the king is liking him because of his character, not the post. So he went in the treasury and he asked 100 rupees or $100, let us say, or 100 gold coins. The treasurer gave him. He told that I am taking it, don't write it anywhere. The next day also he did the same thing. The message went to the king. And the king thought that now the prime minister, once he was very honest, but now he is doing many things wrong. So when he came in the court, the king, he didn't offer chair to his prime minister. Then his prime minister told, I am the same prime minister, but why today you have not offered me the chair? King told, because I have heard that these days you are taking money dishonestly from the treasury. Then the prime minister told to everyone that it's the character due to which I was being revered by the king, not the post. So why I gave this example, that everybody should try to inculcate good habit in the children. For the teachers, you know, there is a saying in Hindi, Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Gurur Deva Maheshwara, means teacher is everything. So you have the great responsibility. You have to carry that responsibility and deliver. Lastly, I will finish my words with the letter that Lincoln wrote when his son was going to the school, to his school teacher. This letter is still relevant. It will take some time, but at the same time, it means a lot. So I'm going to read that before finishing my speech. My son starts school today. It is all going to be strange and new to him for a while, and I wish you would lead him gently. It is an adventure that might take him across continents. All adventures that probably include wars, tragedy, and sorrow. To live this life will require faith, love, and courage. So, dear teacher, will you please take him by his hands and teach him things he will have to know, teaching him but gently if you can. Teach him that for every enemy there is a friend. He will have to know that all men are not just, that all men are not true. But teach him also that for every scoundrel there is a hero, that for every crooked politician there is a dedicated leader. Teach him, if you can, that 10 cents earned is of far more value than a dollar found. In a school, teacher, it is far more honorable to fail than to cheat. And I really believe in that, as I told you, that you should be honest. Teach him to learn how to gracefully lose and enjoy winning when he does win. Teach him to be gentle with people, tough with tough people. Steer him away from envy, if you can, and teach him the secret of quiet laughter. Teach him, if you can, how to laugh when he is sad. Teach him there is no shame in tears. Teach him there can be glory in failure and despair in success. Teach him to scoff at cynics. Teach him, if you can, the wonder of the books, but also give time to ponder the extreme mystery of birds in the sky, bees in the sun, and flowers on a green hill. Teach him to have faith in his own ideas, even if everyone tell him they are wrong. Try to give my son the strength not to follow the crowd when everyone else is doing it. Teach him to listen to everyone, but teach him also to filter all that he hears on a screen of truth and take only the good that comes through. Teach him to sell his talents and brains to the highest bidder, but never to put a price tag on his heart and soul. Let him have the courage to be impatient. Let him have the impatience to be brave. Teach him to have sublime faith in himself, because then he will always have sublime faith in mankind, in God. This is the order, teacher, but see what best you can do. He is such a nice little boy, and he is my son. So with these words, you know, I am from the force. You know about the Central Industrial Security Force. It is one of the paramilitary forces serving at the length and the breadth of the country. So I will always say that we, every work that we are doing, we must think that whether that work is going to help our country or not. In whatever capability you are or capacity you are a teacher, you are a parent, you are working somewhere, try your level best. Don't think that what country can give to you, but what you can offer to country. You should always think about that. Lastly but not least, inculcating good habits, I will also request from the teachers to inculcate good habits means keeping their environment clean, respecting elders. So with these words, I end my words. Thank you so much for giving this occasion. Thank you.